here today. Just got to quickly mention our wonderful sponsors, Zoompa, and there's a prize draw running right now, a chance to win £5,000 of John Lewis vouchers. So if you want to be in with a chance of that, you just need to fill in the entry form and drop it off in the purple mailbox there. Now, we have some top tips coming up for you here on the stage from the wonderful ladies at experthometips.com. So if you've ever wondered about decluttering, about how to make your room look bigger, or you're interested in some weird and wonderful top tips for the home, you are definitely in the right place. We have Anushka and Steph from Expert Home Tips with us today. And I'm just going to wait for this announcement to be over. So, we're going to welcome to the stage Rita.
On the gallery level by the farmers market. Also, if you'd like to
come
would you please make your way to the Olympia Way where you can arrange this? That's how we'll make test driving.
I think this is the longest announcement that I've heard so far since we've been here. Right, anyway, let's get on with it then. Let's bring to the stage Anushka. Welcome.
Thank you very much. Hi everyone, my name is Anushka and I'm from Expert Home Tips. Today I'm going to talk to you about how to declutter your home in order to have a more stress-free life. Right, let's see if we can get this started. Okay. So, what is clutter? Well, clutter is an untidy collection of things. Now, this could be a messy kitchen drawer that you have, which has lots of bits and bobs in it, or it can be a wardrobe full of clothes that you don't wear, bags, shoes, all in some kind of disarray. Now, what we need to do when we're decluttering is we need to identify what type of clutter it is. So we have what I like to call dead clutter. Now this is unused, unwanted items that are just taking up space in your home. So that might be a juicer that you don't use anymore or some clothes that haven't been worn for a few years. And then we have what I like to call living clutter. And this is clutter that serves a purpose. It's things that you need around the home, but they start to accumulate in areas that they don't belong. So say you had a living room and it was full of clutter, and this clutter is essential to your life, but it doesn't belong in your living room. So it may be belongs in your bedroom, or you know, little bits and pieces that accumulate. So once you've identified what type of clutter it is, you can then decide what to do with it. So let's just go back to this one here. Now this drawer here, I'm very ashamed to say, is my drawer at home in my kitchen at the moment. It's a terrible drawer, but who here has a drawer like that at home? Hands up! Glad I'm not the only one, okay? So this drawer is full of what I like to call living clutter. It's stuff I need. There's a dog lead in there, there's a dog poop bag in there, there's an old coaster, and you know, some of these things, you know, they serve a purpose, but they just accumulate in this drawer because they don't have a home to live in. On the right here, again, this is a bedroom. This is not my bedroom. But we have lots of stuff that's probably essential to this person. But again, it's just accumulated and it has no home at the moment. And then what's on the left here is a garage. And this is what I like to call dead clutter, which I mentioned earlier. This might be stuff that is unused, unwanted, and really you need to get rid of it. Either sell it, donate it, bin it, or recycle. And then on the right here is an example of the living clutter again. So this is a living room, and it's got toys, and there's a laptop, and there's some throws, and this is all essential to life, but it's just accumulated in the living room, making it look very untidy. So we just need to find a home for this stuff. So how does clutter make us feel? This is a question I want to ask you guys. When you come back from a busy day at work and you're confronted with mess or clutter in your house, how would that make you feel?
Angry,
exactly. Anybody else? Like, well, for me, it makes me feel stressed, chaotic, frustrated, and also angry. It makes me want to throttle my partner. So these emotions are all linked to that feeling of not being in control. So we let clutter creep into our homes and into our minds. So as they say, to have a tidy home means a tidy mind, and that's what we're trying to achieve with decluttering. So, clutter, reasons to get rid of it now. A tidy, clutter-free home creates a feeling of peace and calm. Now, a good example of this is when you go to a hotel and there's no stuff, there's no junk. It's just got an inviting bed, the surfaces are clean, and it feels very inviting and relaxing. And that's the feeling that we want to create inside our own homes. So we shouldn't be going to a hotel or a guest house or a guest room to feel relaxed. We should try and create that relaxed feeling in our own homes. So removing clutter, not only can it make you feel calm in your own home, but it can also make you feel energized. So when my house is nice and tidy on a Saturday morning, I wake up and it makes me feel energized. It makes me feel like I can do anything with my day. I could potter around the house making things look nice, or I could go out and see a friend. It's that freedom